Hallo en welkom to a new weekend roundup. It's the weekend of 16, 17 and 18 February where we are talking about. And we do a little bit of a roundup from last week. I'm hoping I can do it a little bit faster as last one. Because 42 minutes is a little bit too long. But we starting at my home competition and then we do the top 5 leagues. And, well, I don't know what to say anymore. We're starting with another disappointing week for my home team. And my favorite team, Ajax, again, 2-2 draw. Didn't deserve the draw, to be honest. And it was shit again. Like the last 3 weeks. Oh, that was not what I meant to do. Further on in the competition, top 2 wins again, like, basically every week. Simple victory for PSV, 2-0 against Heracles. Feyenoord only 1-0, even though the opponent had a red card very early in the game. Like in the 35 minutes, well, it's not very early, it's still a lot of time. Stats, 32 shots, 14 on goal, and then 1 goal is not good. 20 lost to FC Utrecht, who are in a ridiculous form right now. 3 victories in a row, and therefore 2 draws. So none losses in the last 5 games. AZ first win since, I don't know, somewhere in 2023. So they finally got 3 points. Ajax we have already spoken about. Gold Eagles is getting back. No losses in the last 5 games. NEC of course draw with Ajax. Sparta winning their derby in Rotterdam with 4-2. After becoming 2-0 down. So that's a good result. Zwolle lost to Almere City. Almere City surprising enough are gonna hang on for another season of the in the highest league in the Dutch. Heerenveen expected a little bit more after a 3-2 win in their home game versus Ajax. Sittard loses for the second week in a row. Heracles loses. Excelsior we have already seen. And then the biggest game of the relegation was basically Volendam versus Vitesse. Both needed to win, both didn't get it because it was a 1-1 draw. So basically no one really provides what they needed. And I think those two are definitely going to the relegate. Maybe Vitesse can something do, but I don't know. Alright, now is the step to the top 5 leagues of the world, the Premier League. And go to the standings, because it's very interesting on what happened this weekend. And that's basically the fight for the title is now wide open, thanks to, who played City all? Oh yeah, Chelsea. Because they managed to get a point. And that means that now if City wins their game in hand, they're not even leading the competition with 13 games to go. Liverpool have it in their own hands now. Of course, a lot of games to go. Still thinking City will manage to win more. But who knows? Who knows? Liverpool kind of a bit setback in the game, even though they won with 4-1. They lost Curtis Jones with an injury. They lost Diogo Jota with an injury. And Darwin Nunez with an injury. So we need to watch what's going to happen with those players. Are the bad injuries? Or like 2 weeks and then they are back and they need to... What's the next game for Liverpool? At home at Luton, so you would think, even though they have those injuries, they should easily win. That's 21. That's not the weekend. That's Wednesday. Why are they playing Wednesday? Is that for the League Cup? That they're playing Wednesday. Arsenal, 5 games in a row wins. They are back in top form. Scoring 5, 7, 10, 16, 21 goals in the last 5. That's madness. That's a lot of goals. Man City, of course, drew against Chelsea. So that is basically a fantastic result for the neutral watcher. Aston Villa wins at Fulham. They needed to do that because Man United are creeping in on those teams. And definitely on Spurs. They lost at home at Wolves. And they will probably feel the pressure of Manchester United now. They're only 3 points difference. The only big thing you see is goal difference. Because goal 35 in the favor, 36, 31, 19, 14. And then you have one. That is still not good. Not good at all. Even Brighton and Newcastle have a way better goal difference. And they are on 38 and 37 points. Brighton, good away win against Sheffield. Newcastle, another disappointing week for them. 2-2 against Bournemouth. And the top 5 is basically gone for them. 10 points. I don't see them close that in. West Ham, another club. What the hell happens with West Ham? They were so good. And suddenly 2 draws. And then 3 losses in a row. Okay, Man United, Arsenal, you can lose them. And then Nottingham should have had a result there. Don't know what happens there. Is there an injury crisis there? Let me watch the lineups. Was there an injury crisis? Paqueta, so no injury crisis, are there? Moyes maybe under pressure there. Chelsea, good draw against City. Nothing to say about that. Last week, Monday, that was after the first roundup on this channel. They won on 3-1 against Crystal Palace. So that's 2 decent results. Wolves are a weird team. They can win from Tottenham and lose from Brentford. Win of Chelsea. Well, United, okay. And lose of a draw to Brighton. 35 points. They are safe from relegation. Maybe if they have a good final 13 games. They have a little shot for 7th in the league. Don't know what that means. I think we only can see that what that means after the League Cup and FA Cup has been played. Fulham, last to Villa. Yeah. Decent team. Not gonna relegate. Not for the European team. That's basically Fulham is and Bournemouth. And maybe Brentford. The only teams right now you can call as boring midfield team. Not gonna relegate, not gonna fight for European spots. And basically just save for another season in the Prem. Nottingham, on this moment, they are safe. They're gonna play another season of Premier League, but if they get the 10 points deduction, then they are not safe at all. So we need to still. I hope it's gonna be very fast if they get it or don't get it, because the fans need and wants to know what the hell is going to happen with Nottingham and Everton are they getting another 10 points? If so, that means Afton are on 9 and are last. Nottingham are on 14 and are in 18th. That's the whole difference of the whole relegation battle. And then Luton are suddenly 16th and nothing on the end and get another season on the Premier League. Burnley, I don't know what the hell, man. So good in the Championship last season. So good. And nothing. Creeping on goals behind. Only 25 goals made in 25 games. A lot of other leagues, the manager would have got the sack a long ago, because it's not working for the top league. Sheffield United have sacked the manager. Now, what are the results? 5-0 lose. Won against Luton. That was a big surprise for me. 5-0 lose, 3-2 lose, and a 2-2 draw. Again, how much times have Sheffield lost 5-0? That's a little bit too much. That are getting results like 5-0 defeats, 6-0 defeats. When they are out the game, they are quite a lot out of the game. What's the next for Sheffield is an away games against Wolves. I don't see them getting a result. I think Wolves gonna win. I'm gonna do this fixtures for the next week. So we have, of course, we have Afton against Crystal. Next year I'm gonna hold my points for that, for predictions. Not for this year, it's way too late. So I'm gonna predict, I think a home win. I think Afton would win this. Then you have a game that is played from round 18 when Man City was on the World Cup of teams. So I think, well, of course it's gonna be a Man City win. I don't see anything other happen than a Man City win. Liverpool Luton, Liverpool win. Chelsea Tottenham is postponed. Villa Nottingham Forest. Surely they're not going to lose 4 home games in a row, Villa. So Villa win. Brighton Everton. Brighton should win that. Crystal Palace Burnley. Oh my god. Yeah. I think a home win. I think a home win. I don't see anything other happen than a home win there. Man United Fulham, again a home win. Again a home win. A lot of home wins this weekend. What I predict. Bournemouth against Man City. I would love a draw, but I think Man City is just too good to win against Bournemouth. Arsenal Newcastle. That's a 9 o'clock game. Arsenal Newcastle. That's a difficult one. Oh my god. I think that's a draw. I really think that's going to be a draw. Wolves Sheffield. Wolves win. West Ham Brentford. That's a Monday game. I think a West Ham win. And with that, we're going to the third league of this week, and that is the Bundesliga. Right, sorry, I need to I don't know what it is, but every time I want to record something, my nose full, and that's annoying. But we are in the Bundesliga, and if this is not the chance Leverkusen needed, then I don't know what they need to get the champion in the German league. Because Bayern München lost the second game in a row. Lost 3-2 against VfL Bochum. Leverkusen still undefeated in the league. 18 wins, 4 draws, 0 losses, 58 points. 8 points clear of Bayern Munich. This is the year. Dortmund bottled it last year. I can't see Leverkusen bottled it this year. I can't see it. They need, of course, still win a lot of games. They can't lose twice games now. In the next 12 games, they can lose 2 games at from them. So yeah, basically, just do your thing. Win your home games. Win a few away games and you are champion of the league. That's basically what they need to do. Stuttgart, good form the last 4 games, all won. A little bit easy last 3 games, but won 5-2 against Leipzig, that's impressive. Dortmund, they not got beaten in the last 5 games. 2 draws, 3 wins, decent form. Of course, not even close to being in the fight for the championship like last year. Leipzig won a game against Gladbach. Yeah, they are in the fight for the top 4. You expect a little bit more from Leipzig. They are not getting that swing to get fighting for the championships. They're not even close. Frankfurt is a team that is on 6th. They have a little gap below them. And a massive gap in front of them. So basically 6th is the best they can do. If they are getting some results. Because they're not so good on the results lately. 3 games in a row already without a win. They only won against Mainz in the last 5 games. And that's the 17th in the league. So yeah. Need a little bit better. Werder Bremen won against Köln 4 out of the last 5. That's a team that is creeping in on Frankfurt. Freiburg on the other hand. No wins in the last 4 games. Only 1 point. And last weekend they drew against Frankfurt. They had a chance to get a little bit back on the top 6. But yeah, they blew it. Did they blew it in the last minute or... No. They just got a draw out of the last minute. Heidenheim. Good season. Just lost to the number 1. So that's not a bad result. Hoffenheim, decent season, lost to Union Berlin, who's getting a little bit on form lately. And maybe they can even end in the top half after that horrific start of the season. Bochum, good season, very good victory last weekend, 3-2 against Bayern Munich. And basically, the midfield team not gonna be in Europe, not gonna relegate. Wolfsburg, that's a bad form last. They're not losing a lot. They're not winning. They drew in 4 or 5 and lost to Union. They need some points. They were in the fight of the European spots, but the last 5 games, they dropped down to 12th and. That's a boring end of the season, probably. Union Berlin, 2 wins in a row. 3 out of the last 5. Only 1 loss. That's a team that have found a little bit of rhythm in the last 5 games. And escaped the relegation zone. Augsburg. They need a little bit to watch out. Last win was in January against Gladbach with a 1-2 victory over them. 23 points. They have a march, so they have a gap to Köln. I don't see them relegate. I think basically a relegation is between the last 3 teams this year. Gladbach. 2 points out of the last 5 games. Lose against Leipzig. Draw against Darmstadt. That was the chance to get a wins in the last 5. Lost against Bayern Munich. Drew against Leverkusen. That's a good draw. And lost against Augsburg. So there are 2 out of the 5 games there were against teams around them. Basically one very bit low between them. But who cares? Köln in a relegation fight. Basically the relegation fight is between Köln, Mainz and Darmstadt. I think Darmstadt is an easy say to get relegated. And it's basically is Mainz or Köln is going to relegate and the other one is going to play the relegation game. Next league. Dum, 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 is the La Liga. So of course, with the most of the competitions, not every game has played. Like this one, Girona are second, but can a little bit close the gap to Real Madrid to 3 points. If they win their difficult away game against Athletic de Bilbao, it's not an easy game to win. But it's if you want to be champion, they need that win. Because basically they need 1 point ahead of Real Madrid. Because Real Madrid have... I believe that in the La Liga it's... if it's 62-62, the team with a better balance between those matches to Girona is getting the place. So if it's 62-62, both are equal on points. They're gonna watch the Real Madrid versus Girona match plays, and the one that got the better results get the first spot. Barcelona, another difficult game, and they won it again in a close fight, 2-1 against Celta, who are a relegation side this year. So that's another. And not so good result of Barcelona. They won. So they can be happy. But how the team perform, it's not very good. Xavi, of course, last year as coach for them. But yeah, still. Not a good result. Sorry for the pauses. Because I need to clear sometimes my nose. And I don't want that to be recorded. Athletic de Bilbao of course plays against Girona, so we don't know the result there. Sociedad, decent season, not that fantastic to be in the top 4 fight. But still in the fight for the European spots. Betis, we can basically say the same. A little bit boring 0-0 of 0-0 draw against Alaves. Valencia, finally a little bit of secure and a little bit of positive season, not fighting around 16th to 12th. And basically finally a bit of calm stand in there. Last 2 games, 1 point, can be better, but still, they are in a sort kind of fight for the European spots. And that was that's not every year they can do that. Las Palmas, big loss to Atletico Madrid, 5-0. With 2 goals of Llorente, 2 goals of Correa and 1 goal of Memphis Depay. What do you have else what is... what you can see and think, what the hell? Vallecano, a little bit of bad form lately. No wins in the last 5 games. Villarreal are a little bit disappointing this season. last five games, four draws and one win. It's not no losses, but you want a little bit more dubs in the last game. 3-5 was the last wins against Barcelona. That's a very nice game. What the hell happened there? It was 1-0 at half time. So the second half exploded. In the what happened in the last 10 minutes? Wow. Big goals in the last in the extra time. Celta de Vigo on the other end. They won against Osasuna. That is the last game they won. The other four games in the last five they lost. So yeah, they are still in that relegation fight. Cadiz, Granada and Almeria are in that relegation spots to get back to La Liga 2. And I don't want to say it, but I think that's gonna be the three. I think it's gonna be Cadiz, Granada and Almeria. Those three are my first pickups for the relegation this year. I don't think anything can happen. You see, two wins in 25 games. That's already bad. Almeria, zero wins. Are you going to get a team that not gonna win one game in the league? That's something to look at. And then for the final league of the week, it's time for the league. Ask him if I can find it. Hello, Ligue 1. Oh, there you are. So, what do we have here? Paris Saint-Germain, 30 points ahead of Brest. Yeah, indeed, Brest. Where the hell did Brest come from? Jesus. They won home a game versus Marseille, but they are now in second. That's a surprise. So. And yeah, Paris Saint-Germain easy going to get champions. It's not a question when, of it's not a question if, but more when they can lift up the title. 12 games to go in the league. 13 points gap between 1 and 2. And basically, you know. Brest are gonna easily not win 9 games. They're not gonna win 9 games out of the last 12. So basically with 6 or 7 wins, Paris Saint-Germain already be champion. Of course we have some big news. Because what we all expected to happen. Mbappé is gonna leave Paris Saint-Germain. And is going to Real Madrid, accusing to some leaks or some. Let me look out for it. It was breaking. Some newspapers, the Marca, reported last week that of reported today that the signing of Kylian Mbappe to Real Madrid is. Basically done, and in 2 weeks it's waiting for the signing of Mbappé to his contract. So that's going to be it's going to be a big Madrid team again, and that is going to be a problem in the Champions League next year. Not gonna lie, Nice. Bad form last three games. They need to improve fast. Because if they don't, they are having a trouble in from their top three spots. And by the way, oh my god. Do you see what I'm seeing? Do you see what I am seeing? 22 games played. 22 goals made. 15 goals against. That's so boring. Nice. You have supporters. What are you doing? 1-0. 2-3. Kijk, ik had de true 3. 0-0, 1-0, 2-0. That's boring as fuck. That's basically below 2 goals average a game. Below 2 goals average a game. Lille, they are in the fight with Nice, Monaco, Lens. And even Stade Rennes, another win of Stade Rennes. We had last week, they had already 5 games won in a row. They're now on 6 games won in a row. So they are, yeah, they are having a time of their life. Best form in the league. You can see here, 5. In the last 10 games, they are 3rd in the league. Only Brest are better than them, and of course Paris Saint-Germain and Brest are not better because that's equal on points, but the better goal difference. Who was the worst in the last 10? That's Metz, probably also last in the standings. Oh no, second last. Okay, there's a bit of form for bit of form. That's a fantastic form. What's the next game? Well, they're gonna lose their streak, because the next game is away against Paris Saint-Germain. What's the other team that is surprisingly in form? Well, not surprisingly, you expect they're gonna do something like this. But it's Lyon, 3 games in a row, all with the closest margin you can win. 2-1, 1-0 and 1-0. They got their defensive working, and there are not completely out of the relegation. You can't deny that. They are not completely out. Because the gap for them to the 16th place is only 3 points. So they can't afford to have a losing streak. Le Havre. Bad form. Need to watch out. Basically, from Strasbourg to Nantes, all the teams need to watch out for their form. Lorient, 3 games in a row they won. They were last, and now they are 15th. That's quickly how things can change. Last 3 places, Nantes. They have 1 game won in the last 5 games. Is that good enough to be safe at the end of the season? I don't think so. Then Metz and Clermont, I don't think they will win spots. I think that's the two teams that are gonna relegate. But who's gonna be 16th in that roster? I have no clue. I have literally no clue. It can be Nantes, it can be Lorient, Montpellier, Toulouse, Le Havre, Lyon, official again. Don't think they will. Next game is against Metz. They can win their 4th game in a row. Strasbourg. Yeah. They have a bad form, so you don't know. Marseille is safe for me. Although Gattuso say they're not. And that they are in a relegation form. Yeah, I can see that a bit, but they have 30 points. They have the margin to the teams below, so don't think they're gonna relegate. I'm gonna quickly look at some second league competitions. That's just only standings and then blah blah blah. I go. Leicester, easy gonna be back in the Premier League next year. Good form for Leeds, by the way. 5 games in a row they won. Basically, the relegations of last season are 1, 2, 3. So maybe that's the clausule they got from relegating from the Premier League is now working really. Because, yeah, that's a sign. That's not a good sign. Norwich, decent form. Fully in the fight of the playoffs this year. Same thing for Hull. Only lost in the last 5 games against Swansea. Swansea are 18th in the league. They only won in the last 5 games against Hull. That's a funny thing. Hull only lost 1 game against the last 5 against the 1. team that only won one game in the last five. Rotterdam, they're gonna relegate, that's easy. That's easy. Sheffield Wednesday, good win against Millwall. Millwall are... Oh my god. Oh my god, Millwall. What is happening to Millwall? Are Millwall going to relegate to League One? On form, you will say yes. On form, Millwall are going to relegate to League One. Ooh, Mr. Zirka will not be happy with that. QPR only lost one game in the last five. That's what I mean with on form. QPR have a decent form the last five games. Sheffield, even Sheffield are doing better in the last five games. And then the last league before I gonna head off is the second Bundesliga. Hamburg, I'm going to bottle another season of the second Bundesliga. I'm not going to be back in the first another year, because they are having not so good of form. And Hannover on the other side below them, 4 games, 1 in a row. Do we see something surprising on the downside? I think Schalke is finally getting their bread to save them from even relegating another league down. With 2 wins in the last 3 games. They're now on 26 points. They're not clear, but they have got now some breathing space. Osnabrück definitely gonna relegate back to third Liga. And then it's basically seeing what out of Hansa Rostock, Kaiserslautern, Braunschweig. Maybe Schalke, Mayen and Magdeburg. But don't think so. Alright, that is the roundup for this weekend. We have the, of course, All-Star weekend, so not a lot of happened in the basketball scenes. The East won a game against West for the All-Star game. First time that a team in All-Star game got 200 points. 211 to 186 of them. Top score of the game was, funny enough, the one that lost. And that was Karl Anthony Towns with 50 points, 8 rebounds, 3 assists. And for the East side, it was Lillard with 39 points. But yeah, nothing to say about it. No one really cares about it. And that's pretty much everything what important to say. We have got the Dutch Open in the tennis world. And I believe Sinner won it. Was expected. He was the first seeded player in the tournament. And he did exactly what he needed to do. And basically ended a good tournament in Rotterdam. Didn't see a lot of it. But yeah. That's something for another channel. Not my channel. But okay, this was the roundup. The second roundup on the channel. And we going to head off for this week. And hopefully I can see you next week again. So basically subscribe to the channel. Press the like button. And follow the other channel in the descriptions below. And see you next week. Bye.